हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल मेडिकल बायोकेमिस्ट्री बाय डॉक्टर वसंत गोसाई। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट किडनी फंक्शन टेस्ट। एंड इन किडनी फंक्शन टेस्ट, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नेफ्रॉन, विच इज़ द फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ द किडनी। एंड इट इज़ कंपोज ऑफ बाउमेन्स कैप्सूल विथ ग्लोमेरुलर टर्व ऑफ कैपिलरीज, द प्रॉक्सिमल कॉन्वोल्यूटेड ट्यूब्यूल्स पीसीटी, लूप ऑफ हेनले, डिस्टल कॉन्वोल्यूटेड ट्यूब्यूल्स एंड कलेक्टिंग ट्यूब्यूल्स। नाउ अप्रोक्सीमेटली 1 मिलियन नेफ्रॉन इन ईच किडनी एंड 1200 ml ब्लड पासिस थ्रू किडनी इन 1 मिनट। द मेजर फंक्शंस ऑफ द किडनीज आर एक्सक्रीशन ऑफ द यूरिया एंड अदर वेस्ट सच एज एसिड्स, बेस, टॉक्सिन्स, ड्रग मेटाबोलाइट्स, यूरिया, क्रिएटिनिन। सेकंड वन इज द मेंटेनिंग द वाटर बैलेंस, एक्सक्रीशन ऑफ द सोडियम विच इफेक्ट ऑन द ब्लड प्रेशर, देन एक्सक्रीशन ऑफ द पोटेशियम विच इफेक्ट ऑन द हार्ट रिदम, देन एक्सक्रीशन ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन आयन्स विच मेंटेन द पीएच ऑफ द ब्लड, देन एक्टिवेशन ऑफ द विटामिन डी विच इफेक्ट ऑन बोन, देन प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द इरिथ्रोपोएटिन, फिल्ट्रेशन एंड रीअब्सॉर्प्शन। In reabsorption, all the glucose and amino acid are reabsorbed, most of sodium and chloride also reabsorbed. Now classification of the renal function test. First one is to screen for kidney diseases, which is detected by the complete urine analysis by measuring its volume, the appearance of the urine odor, its color, its reaction with the litmus, and by seeing the presence of the some chemicals, substances, proteins, blood, reducing sugars, ketone bodies, bile salt and bile pigment, and also the non-protein nitrogen substances like urea, creatinine and uric acid. Then by estimation of the plasma urea and creatinine and electrolyte concentration in the blood. Second one, renal function test is divided into two categories. First one is to assess the glomerular function by glomerular filtration rate, then by detecting the glomerular permeability to detect the proteinuria. Then second one is to assess the tubular functions by detecting the reabsorption studies, by secretion studies, then the concentration and dilution test, and in last the renal acidification. Now the glomerular function. When the blood is perfused through the Bowman's capsule, an ultrafiltrate of the blood is produced in the glomerulus, while the cells and the proteins are retained in the blood. So here the earliest manifestation of the abnormal function of the glomeruli is the appearance of the albumin in the urine. So glomerular filtration rate is a very useful index for assessment of the severity of the renal damage. And the measurement of the clearance, like urea clearance test, creatinine and urinalyl clearance test, they are predominantly used as a test of the glomerular filtration rate. Now we will see about renal threshold and tubular maximum. So first of all, we will discuss about threshold substances. What are threshold substances? So they are the compounds whose excretion in urine are dependent on the blood level. And the renal threshold of the substance is the plasma level above which the compound is excreted in the urine. And what is tubular maximum? What is TM? So it is the capacity, it is the maximum reabsorptive capacity of the substances. It's called the tubular maximum. Now here the example of the glucose. For the glucose, the renal threshold is 180 milligram per deciliter and TM value is 375 milligram per minute. In other words, the glucose starts to appear in the urine when blood level is more than 180 milligram per deciliter. And all the glucose molecules are above 375 milligram are excreted in the urine. Now we will see about clearance. What is clearance? So it is the volume of the blood or the plasma which is completely cleared of a substance per unit time, ml per minute. Now, the relationship of the GFR with the clearance. When the substance is filtered but neither reabsorbed nor secreted, so the result is GFR is equal to clearance. And it is here the best example is the inulin, which means inulin is neither secreted nor reabsorbed. Then second one is the when the substance filtered but partially reabsorbed, so the clearance is less than GFR and its best example is the urea. Then third mechanism is the when the substance filtered, secreted but not reabsorbed, so the clearance is more than the GFR and its example are the diodrast and para-amino epuric acid. Now we will see the calculating formula of the urea clearance test and creatinine clearance test. Normally clearance is equal to milligram of the substance excreted per minute divided by milligram of the substance per ml of the plasma, and it is calculated by using the formula C is equal to U multiply with V divided by P, where U is concentration of the substance in the urine, P is the concentration of the substance in plasma or the serum, and V is the ml of the urine excreted per minute. In urea clearance, the urea clearance is calculated by the formula U multiply with V divided by P, where the U is the milligram of urea per ml of the urine, P is the milligram of urea per ml of plasma, and V is ml of urine excreted per minute. And this is called the maximum urea clearance, and the normal value is found to be 75 ml per minute. But the clearance value is decreased when volume of the urine is less than 2 ml per minute, and then it is called standard urea clearance, where the normal value is found to be 54 ml per minute, and it is calculated as U multiplied with under root V divided by P. Now in creatinine clearance test, patient is asked to take 500 ml water to promote the good urine flow, and after 30 minutes and after 60 minutes patient is asked to discard the urine, then collect the urine and note the volume of the urine, then take one sample of blood also. Then creatinine level in blood and urine are tested and calculated. Then by using the creatinine clearance formula, UV by P multiply with 1.73 divided by A ml per minute, and it is calculated. The normal range of creatinine clearance is 95 to 105 ml per minute. Creatinine is the most widely used biomarker of the kidney function, and generally it is considered as reflecting the GFR. The creatinine production is dependent on the muscle mass, and it is not only filtered by the glomeruli but also it is secreted by the renal tubules. And this tubular secretion contributes approximately 10% of the total creatinine excretion by kidney, and it can increase as GFR decreases. So one thing remember that the normal serum creatinine may be observed in the individual with significantly impaired GFR. Serum creatinine does not increase until the GFR has moderately decreased about 40 ml per minute. And this insensitivity to small to moderate decrease in GFR is called as a creatinine blind GFR area, which is 40 to 70 ml per minute. Now here you can see the normal reference values of the serum creatinine and the GFR. In for adult male, the serum creatinine value is 0.7 to 1.4 milligram per deciliter, and its GFR value is 95 to 115 ml per minute, and for adult female the serum creatinine value is 0.6 to 1.3 milligram per deciliter, and its GFR value is 85 to 110 ml per minute, and for children it is 0.5 to 1.2 milligram per deciliter. Now here the factors which are reducing serum creatinine level. First one is the low muscle mass, second one is the malnutrition, and some medicines like thiazide and vancomycin, they can also reduce the serum creatinine value. Then the factors which increasing this serum creatinine, first one is the old age, then the renal diseases like renal failure, then congestive cardiac failure, and some and also some medicines which increases the serum creatinine value, and they are amphotericin B, captopril, cephalosporins and kanamycin. Now here is a simple technique of estimating the creatinine clearance and GFR by using the serum creatinine level, and this would eliminate the need for the time urine collections. It is so important. A commonly used formula is Cockcroft-Gault equation, and by this equation the creatinine clearance is equal to 140 minus age in the years multiply with weight in kilogram, and if female patient it multiply with 0.85 which divided by 72 multiply with plasma creatinine concentration in milligram per deciliter, and here the factor 0.85 is used in female assuming that they have 15% less muscle mass. Then second, a more recent equation used in the MDRD modification of diet in renal disease study, which is more accurate, and this equation directly estimates the glomerular filtration rate, and here the estimated GFR is equal to 186 multiply with creatinine divided by 88.4 minus 1.154 multiply with age minus 0.203 multiply with 0.742 if female patient. This eGFR can only be used accurately in patients with the chronic kidney diseases. Now we will see the most important parameter, cystatin C, which is more precise test of the kidney function than the serum creatinine levels. Cystatin C, its high concentration in the biological fluid like breast milk, tears and saliva, and it expressed in virtually all organs of the body, and it is produced at a constant rate by all the nucleated cells, and it has no diurnal variations. Its levels are not altered by the inflammatory conditions and also not influenced by the diet and the muscle mass. It has free renal filtration with no tubular secretion and no re-entry into the circulation, and its tubular reabsorption is followed the degradation. Multiple studies have found that the cystatin C to be more sensitive to the actual changes in the GFR in the early stages of the chronic kidney disease than the creatinine-based GFR estimates. Now we will see the advantages of the cystatin C over the creatinine. Here the cystatin C is unaffected by the non-renal factors like muscle mass, weight or height, genders, and less inter-individual variations. Cystatin C is able to detect early detection and treatment of the CKD. It has no blind area and will therefore show a true positive reduction of the GFR. Cystatin C predicts the mortality while creatinine does not see the mortality. Now we will see the markers of the glomerular permeability. Here the glomerulus act as a selective filter of the blood passing through its capillaries, and the passage of the macromolecules is restricted based on their charge, size and the shape. The low molecular weight proteins are freely filtered, reabsorbed and catalyzed by the renal tubular cells. The appearance of the significant quantities of the proteins like albumin indicates the increase the glomerular permeability, which is we known as a proteinuria. Now here the indications and types of the proteinuria. It is useful for diagnosis of the nephrotic syndrome, useful for the prognosis of the progressive renal diseases, for the diagnosis of the early diabetic nephropathy. Here the early stages of diabetic nephropathy are characterized by the increase in the GFR value, microalbuminuria and hypertension. Now the types of the proteinuria. First one is called the glomerular proteinuria, which is due to the glomerular damage and vascular permeability. Second one is the overflow proteinuria, which is increased circulating concentration of the low molecular weight protein. And third one is the tubular proteinuria, which is decrease in reabsorptive capacity due to tubular damage. Now we will see the glomerular proteinuria. The glomeruli of the kidney are not permeable to the substances with molecular weight more than 69,000 dalton, and so plasma proteins are absent in normal urine. But when the glomeruli are damaged or diseased, they become more permeable and plasma protein may appear in the urine. Albuminuria is always pathological. The large quantities, a few gram per day of albumin, are lost in urine in the nephrosis. When the presence of albumin in urine is 300 milligram per day, it is called the benign proteinuria. In pathological proteinuria, its concentration is 300 milligram to 1000 milligram per day. And when its concentration is more than 1000 milligram per day, it is called glomerular proteinuria. Now we will see the microalbuminuria, which is called as minimal albuminuria, and it is identified when the small quantity of the albumin, the concentration is 30 to 300 milligram per day, is seen in the urine. This test is not indicated in the patient with overproteinuria. Early morning mid-strip sample is preferred for this test, and microalbuminuria is an early indication of the nephropathy in the patients with the diabetes mellitus and the hypertension. So all the patients who are non-diabetic and hypertensive should be screened for the microalbuminuria, and it is the early indicator of onset of the nephropathy. It is expressed as the albumin creatinine ratio. The normal ratio is in males is less than 23 milligram per gram of the creatinine, and in females it is less than 32 milligram per gram of the creatinine. So patients having the higher value on more than one occasion are considered to have the microalbuminuria. Now overflow proteinuria. When small molecular weight proteins are increased in the blood, they overflow into the urine. And for example, in hemolytic condition, the hemoglobin which appear in the urine, which is called hemoglobinuria. And second is the myoglobinuria, which is seen in following the muscle crush injury. Another example is the Benjohn's protein, which is present in the multiple myeloma. Then third one is the tubular proteinuria, and this occur when the functional nephrons are reduced, GFR is decreased and remaining nephrons are overworking. The tubular reabsorption mechanism is impaired. So low molecular weight proteins like retinol binding protein and alpha 1 microglobulins, they appear in the urine. Now the test for the tubular functions. First one is the specific gravity of the urine, and this is the simplest test for the tubular function. Second one is the measurement of the osmolality. The osmolality of the urine sample vary from 60 milliosmol per kg to 1200 milliosmol per kg, and in patient of the nephrogenic diabetes insipidus, the osmolality is less than 300 milliosmol per kg. Then third one is the concentration test. Then fourth one is the dilution test. Here the patient is not allowed to drink the water after the midnight, and bladder is emptied at 7 a.m. and then water load is given around 1200 ml for next 30 minutes. Then hourly collect the urine sample for next 4 hours separately. After that, the volume, specific gravity and osmolality of the each samples are measured. And dilution test is more sensitive and less harmful than the concentration test. Now, fifth one is the urinary acidification test, and it is indicated in unexplained hyperchloremic metabolic acidosis. Here, the acidification defects may occur due to the generalized tubular defects or due to genetically determined defects in the iron pumps. Sixth one is the fractional excretion of the bicarbonate, and here the fractional excretion of the bicarbonate is calculated by a urine bicarbonate value multiplied with the plasma creatinine divided by plasma bicarbonate multiplied with the urinary creatinine which is multiplied with the 100. Normal fractional excretion of the bicarbonate is less than 15%, and if its level is more than 20%, it confirms the type 2 renal tubular acidosis. Then seventh one is a fractional excretion of the sodium, and it is the sodium clearance as a percentage of the creatinine clearance. Eighth one is a fractional excretion of the phosphate, and it is used in diagnosis of the hypophosphatemia. Now the immunological test used in the renal diseases. So first one is the test of the complement component, which is used to diagnose the post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, acute nephritis syndrome, and renal failure with skin or neurological involvement. Second one is the immunoglobulin and electrophoresis test for the paraproteinemias. Then anti-neutrophil cytoplasmic antibodies test to detect the crescentic glomerulonephritis. Then anti-GBM antibodies test to detect the good pasture syndrome. Thank you for watching this video, and please like, share and subscribe this YouTube channel, and press the bell icon to get the notification of this channel. Thank you.